Okay, we're in. We're in. We've actually loaded in. Actually, let's do this first. I pressed the wrong button. Hello, guys, and welcome back. We're here with our final game of the day, and now we can switch back into the draft. Mama's Boys against Wombat Gaming for WePlay Season 3, European West Group Stage. And we've had a decent day so far. One SEA game. This is going to be the second EUS game. We didn't have our CIS region game today because it got postponed until a later date. But let's get things kicked off, shall we? Draft has begun. Heroes are being banned out. My co-caster here with me, March. It's been a long day. We've had three best of ones, but we've been here for a good 7 or 8 hours. There's been a couple of little breaks in between, but they've been fun games. They have been super intense games.
Yeah, it was kind of quick, though, but Radiant I like the games. Pick. It was interesting to see how the meta's evolving.
Yeah, good to see some teams performing as well. London Conspiracy, they've had a good run recently. Stake, not such a good time of late, but Spirit Wombat Breaker. Gaming, this is a name that I didn't Dire know when team. It first came up on the schedule, but I do know a bunch of these players. German team, Vino, Shaq, Aria, Rain, and Y50. I know three of them. I know Vino, Shaq, and Aria. Shaq Radiant played for like Abraxas, Goomba, Vino played for Goomba as well. And these are all like 6-7k MMR players Oracle. In Europe. So they're, you know, they're decently skilled players. They're Radiant a pretty good team back. From what I've heard. But up against Mama's Boys, you know, X4CNL, they've brought in Hook. They've still got Saxa, Bambo, and they've got Yapzor now, as well as Pycat, the old guard. Mama's Boys did so well. So well in the open qualifiers, went into the closed qualifiers for the Shanghai Major. And I was really, really kind of upset that they didn't, you know, go further than I thought they would do. But they're still a very strong team. And up against Wombat, I think this should be... If there are no surprises thrown at us, I think this is probably going to be a clear-cut win for Mama's Boys. But you never know. Shaq for Wombat Gaming, 7k player, Invoker, Meepo, Spammer. I've come across him in my ranked pubs. He's ridiculously good. I've met him in real life as well. We did Red Bull Gaming Grounds back in... Oh, goodness, I don't know. Last year sometime, where we had two German teams play against each other. Shaq was there, as well as like EDE and Vivi Vambo. And Shaq is a really chill dude. He's chill in real life. He's one of those guys though in pub games that will feed couriers. He will be a little bit naughty from time to time, but I think he's going to be the star here that we really have to watch out for.
Isn't Hook also a rising star? Remaining. I've been following the Mala Boys quite a bit, so I watch a lot of their games. Reserve time. Pycat and Sexy Bamboo are good friends of mine actually. So
yeah, Hook. Hook used to play with Miracle. Like, a lot of people don't realize this, but back at the start of last year, Miracle, Hook, there was a Jordanian team called Four Bunnies, One Turtle, and it was a team that I followed for a long time, and it was one of the first times I really saw Ember Spirit utilized amazingly well, was when Miracle was playing Ember Spirit back in, like, March or something like that, and he would go, like, Yule Scepter on Ember Spirit when he was behind, and I was just amazed by it. But Hook was playing with him then, and he is definitely a very skilled player. Yapzor, I love him. The dude is amazing. He's a funny guy. He's an amazing player. But Mama's Boys are like this sort of semi-all-star team. You know, Pycat, he's been on LGDN. He's been on some really high-profile teams, Alliance and things like that. Yapzor and Hook haven't had that real big burst of popularity or anything like that. Saxa was like one of the first people to reach 7-8 KMMR. Remaining. And Bambo is just like, you know, the Dutch god. He is the best. He is the best, you know?
He was in Korea for in the team Zephyr with Blitz, and then I had to play against him for a lot of times. Reserve
time. What's he like in real life? What's he like in real life?
He's like... it's inappropriate to say in casting.
You can say whatever you want. You can do whatever you want.
I don't think Babbitt wants me to talk about what he's like in real life.
For me, I've met him like 3 or 4 times. We met at like the TI5 qualifier hub. We've met at a couple of events. He's like a cartoon character for me. Like, honestly, he's like a cartoon character. He's so like energetic and he's always smiling. He's a funny little dude.
I remember at the TI4 where he just bought a ticket to Seattle and came to the hotel and just asked random people so he can sleep at the hotel.
Oh, can I stay with you? Can I stay with you?
yeah, and then eventually he stayed with Blitz. I don't remember someone. Yeah, he just stayed with someone.
Well, back to the draft we go. Mama's Boys, Sven, Batrider, Ventral Spirit. So they've got bonus armor from Warcry, negative armor from Wave of Terror, but Wombat Gaming. Oracle against Batrider, So they've got that good old ultimate to try and get that lasso off. Spirit Breaker pretty good at chasing down heroes like Venge, but there's a bunch of stuns here to stop him. Flame Break probably going to be the key one there. But Wombat seem very intent on trying to counteract this initiation. You know, Oracle, Spirit Breaker, Witch Doctor. They've got some good initiation, but this feels like they're going to go heavy counter-initiation just to try and stop Mammoth Boys from doing so well, in addition to the laning power from Witch Doctor Oracle. The healing, the sustain, the lockdown. I think that's the way to go, if Wombat can get a good foothold in the lanes. What do you think?
At first, I was like, when Oracle came out, I was thinking heroes like Chan, Witch Doctor, to synergize the heals are pretty good. And looking at just the draft, Mammoth Boys' draft is actually very similar to the State Gaming, just the opening where they pick the Vengeful Spirit and the Batrider. So I think they're just I think it's something like the European meta where all the European teams first to pick Vengeful Spirit and Batrider to start off, and then Wombat Gaming seems like they have their own strategy, and then that's when you pick a Spirit Breaker versus. You don't first pick the Spirit Breaker usually, and now Mammoth Boys has a lot of counters to Spirit Breaker. This dress looks interesting.
I'll let you know why. The Spirit Breaker is like a favorite hero of Vino. I'm not sure if he's playing offlane for this team, but back when he was playing for other German teams, they would always first pick Spirit Breaker for him. Like, he's a good offlane player. You know, he plays like a decent Darkseer, a decent Clock, decent Beast. You know, he plays decently in the offlane. But Spirit Breaker is like that one hero that he's good at. That's like his sort of exceptional hero. That's his sort of signature hero is the Spirit Breaker. So it's not... like, it's not amazingly super surprising for me knowing the players, but I agree with you. Meta-wise, I don't think it's the way to go to open your draft with a Spirit Breaker. But Razor, again, good laning hero, very solid, good at counter-initiating and stopping Mama's Boys getting too up in their face. But where do they, like, objective taking, team fight taking, Wombat Gaming just seem to be, I don't know, they seem to be lacking something.
Well, it's different from all the other games we had, both of the teams are not looking to push at the moment. And it seems like we're going to have a longer games than the other ones.
No one's going to go and destroy tier 1, tier 2 towers as he reaches like 5 or 6 minutes. I mean, the last game we saw, State Gaming got demolished in 19 minutes and 10 seconds by London Conspiracy. But then again, they had Brood, Chen, Beastmaster, Lycan. They had, you know, four heroes that could summon units with the Howl, and it was just tower after tower. And guys, I'm not German. Come on, Llama Down Under's trolling you. I'm not German. I live in Berlin, but I'm from England. If anybody thinks I have a German accent, you are full on insane. 10 out of 10 insanity. So ban wise here, Wombat Gaming probably looking for a safe lane hero. Morphling, yep. That's one of Shaq's. Shaq plays like Tinker, Invoker, Morphling, Meepo. You know, those heroes you kind of expect from pub stompers, right?
Yep. I think Batrider is going to be an offlane hero, loading Sexy Bamboo. He really likes that hero. And from what I've seen from the qualifier games, Hook seemed to be somewhat of the semi-carry player. I think Quap would be a good hero against Razor.
Oh,
never mind. I guess it's mid Batrider again.
Yeah, Hook was like the mid sort of semi carry. Pycat played safe lane from qualies, right? And then you had Yapzor, Sax to support Bambo off lane. I think this is. I still agree with you. I think. I still think this could be off lane Batrider. We've seen some tinkering with like dual lanes mid. I don't know. It's gonna be Bambo Sand King, isn't it?
Yeah, I guess so. Remaining. I don't think Sand King can lane against Razor if Razor gets pulled Sentry Wards.
5 seconds remaining.
Well, final pick. What we're looking at, Wombat. What are we Reserve looking at? Time. Something that can dish out a ton of damage, because right now you've got a lot of healing and sustain. You've got some decent team fight, but you don't have any like innate synergy between these heroes. What could we go for? Lone Druid was banned out
Ten
in the
seconds
final.
Remaining.
Ban phase by Wombat, so maybe...
5 seconds.
Oh, wow, okay. This is out a lot of damage. Good early game hero. And a tanky frontliner. Something
Wombat
to fight
Wombat seems so tanky. Like, all those five heroes look so tanky.
Do you think Mama's Boys have enough nuke damage and control to bring them down?
Well, they actually do. Like, a Sand King is, like, really good. Like, they can lasso one guy, and if he lasso the guy at the right position, seeing where Oracle is, they can pull them back, and then Wombat Gaming has to chase in to save that guy, and Zant King's gonna counter initiate again. I can see Mama Boys doing well in the team fight, but if Oracle is in the right position, canceling the Batriders, lasso, Wombat Gaming will take the fights after that.
Well, we'll see where they go. It's actually going to be Arya on the Wraith King, Shaq Razor, Rain Oracle, Y50 Witch Doctor, and yeah, Vino on that Spiritbreaker. Like I was saying, it's kind of his hero. Saxa on the Vengeful Spirit, as we do not forget to change the overlay. Switch that over. Nicely done. And we're ready to get into things. So yeah, Bambo Sand King, Hook Batrider, Pycat Sven. Yaps are on the Rubik, and Saxa playing in the Vengeful Spirit. And who was the last one we missed out on? Oh, it was just Vino on the Spirit Breaker, yeah. It looks like they want to get over to this dire side camp for the offlane as quickly as they can. I guess Sand King can kind of abuse that if he's offlane. Stack this camp multiple times and sandstorm it down. Next to that tier 2 down at bottom. I guess if you place the
sentry
down there.
I tried Sand King offlane with the new map. And then like you get boost like Sexy Bamboo, and then you just run around the map and stack once in a while, and then like clear the camp after. It's pretty useful.
He's got boots and a fairy fire. What were they saying before? They were saying good luck, have fun. Cute little smiley faces as well. Saxa, quick and early movement towards the mid. Sword gets placed. I thought he was going to ward Ancients or something there for a second, but he doesn't go for it. And Vino on the Spirit Breaker. Get his obs down there as well. And look at this. Mama's Boys. They're the ones who actually get over towards this side camp, so it's not sentried up. And they make damn sure that Bambo has that available for him.
I like that kind of play. And like whenever you have a Darkseer and a hero that can abuse that jungle, like you should protect it. Oh! There's blood.
Poor Shaq. Stun into stun into right click to death.
First blood on
the Razor walked up the wrong stairway there. His Mama's Boys are waiting for him. Now they're taking good control of this jungle, and even this laning ward here, looking for the Sand King to move across. His Observer Ward is already down. So they're not going to see where he's placed it.
They might lose both rooms. This is a terrible start for the Mama Boys. I mean, Wombat Gaming.
The battle begins.
Double Bambo getting this rune, honestly. Look at that. He's more than halfway to level 2. This is a great start for him, you're right. So Oracle, gonna have your life pretty difficult here. Even with a Witch Doctor try and help you. Up against Bambo on this Sand King. Oh goodness. So Batrider mid up against the Razor. Now we're going to start things off. Who gets the first last hit? No, it's the Batrider. He starts things off well. Vino Spirit Breaker. Can, like, once Spirit Breaker hits level 2 and Razor hits level 3, they could potentially kill the Bat here. But then you've got to think about TP rotations from, like, Saxa and Yapzor. The Rubik Venge are great reactionary supports. They can TP in, Telekinesis, stun, and they're going to start things off here on the Spirit Breaker. He hasn't leveled up charge yet. I don't know if they're going to wait for it. No, those go Telekinesis, but he can charge away now. Runs himself through the supports and cancels it out at the last second to salve himself up and return to lane. I mean, they expended a decent amount of mana there, but they can go. Actually, no, they can't. There's no Mango on Pycat, so they can't go again.
Actually, one of my most played hero is Spirit Breaker when I was playing competitive. And I know what to do in this kind of matchups. Like, you kind of want to just run to mid and force a reaction and just run back to top. So one support TPs to the mid lane, and then when you go back to the lane, there's only two people. So you can like reach off experience and stuff like that. I want to see if he does similar stuff. Just like, because you said he's a really good Spirit Breaker player.
Oh, he's going to get caught here. It's definitely one of his more comfortable heroes. Oh, he's going to dodge this. The stun comes out. Vengeful Spirit catches him. And Pycat yet to have mana for it. He pops his war cry, but they've got Telekinesis and enough damage here, surely. They'll just click him down as middle lane. We miss out on a big dive from Hook. Chases Shaq between tier 1 and tier 2.
Oh.
I'm not sure how that happens. Razor's level 3 there. Still drops. I mean, Hook is full health. So he must have had a creep wave with him when he dived onto tier 1.
Yeah, people need to be careful about playing against the bat. If there's a lot of wave, the bat can just like... Bat doesn't have to right-click you. All his damage comes from the firefly and the stacked sticky napalm. So he doesn't need to take the aggro from the tower. So it's really dangerous for him.
Bambo is level 2.5. He's got his tranquils though. That's the biggest thing. With tranquils up, he's very quick on his feet and he can start roaming around the map and looking for these aggressive, forceful plays. And kind of the similar plays that you're looking for the Spirit Breaker, maybe. Force reactions. Maybe kill off this Razor a couple of times. You even see the Oracle coming in. Hook, 5, 6 stacks up on that sticky napalm. He's got Firefly as well. And Shaq, he's just going to get burnt to death. Hook will drop here, though, to the Oracle under the tower. And the charge was coming across, but this is still going to be a decent trade-off there as Hook gets the golden experience. And they also allow Sexy Bambo to come in and get his level 3 from this lane.
The Razor is that type of a hero that can come back from the slow starts. Like heroes like Lycan from the last game, like that hero comes problems really fast so he can come back. But it's really bad for the Razor to have a slow start. You pick him to dominate the lanes, not to lose the lanes.
Yeah, he can't necessarily flash farm. He's not a good ganking hero either. Like he can't rotate into a lane and necessarily force things to happen. Maybe he can bait them up on this top lane and TP in to react, but it's going to be a rough ride for him. The fact that now Hook has Magic 1 Bottle Boots. I wonder if he goes into that rushed Blink Dagger like we saw in the previous game, but still, this Spirit Breaker up at top hasn't made a mark on this game just yet. Level 2, no charges connecting just yet. Well, Sexy Bambo is about to hit level 3 with a second bounty rune of the game. There we go, level 2 Sandstorm. He doesn't have a stack available for him though just yet.
He was trying to stack it, I think he messed up on the timing, I guess. Or... I tested the pull cap here, it's like pretty difficult, the size is really big, so you have to cut the tree and pull it to the right, or like pull it to the upside, like pulling it this way doesn't really work, the downwards.
Yeah, both of the offlane camps are kind of awkward. Like, we were looking at the hitbox of the one up here, and the hitbox on the Radiant one is pretty massive, it's like... Just a huge box all around the camp.
Yeah, like, on the Radiant, there's a tip like where you cut this tree down, and then you can pull it this way, check the runes and stuff like that too.
Okay.
I don't know. I stopped playing competitive after the maps changed, so I don't really know.
Spirit Breaker, you can charge. Should be okay here. There's no secondary stun from the Vengeful Spirit. She was a little bit late to the party, but you know the Radiant's Spirit Breaker yet to hit level 3. Attack. While Bambo is having a free time down at bot, they have a sentry placed already. Radiant Sentry and Observer Ward there to try and scout them out, but they're diving under this top tier one. There's no charge, there's no mana for another 6 seconds or so, but they've got the lift and the hits in there as Sven cleaves him into the ground with that big old sword. I'll try and take this tier one, maybe with the next creep wave coming in. But I think now the Spirit Breaker knows there's an Observer Ward up on that spire. They've got full vision of him. They know exactly what's going on. How's mid doing for Shaq? 8-2. Oh, I've not seen a mid lane like this in a long, long time.
Like, so what are the heroes that does well against Batrider? Oh, I guess Broodmother.
Yep, Broodmother. I guess Queen of Pain, because she can blink away from like Sticky Napalm. I don't know, does Viper do okay?
Viper does fine, I guess.
It's an awkward one, huh? I guess Zeus...
I thought Razor would do okay as well.
Yeah. I kind of thought so too. The fact you can like static link, you've got plants of field. I guess Zeus is a good one as well. The fact you just stay out of napalm range. And you never get chased down. Just keep zapping
them with
lightning.
I think it has to do something with the Banyu runes, like that he wasn't able to pick the Banyu rune and then Batrider was. So that's why he had an edge at early levels and then dove him at the tower.
Yeah, you had that deficit very early on, and here we go, into the lasso. Yep, no, yep, there we go. The static link is still going, and Shaq, oh, that's a good cast from the Witch Doctor catching out Hook, and they've got the nuke damage to bring him down. He'll finally
really
get something. Finally get something. They're going to go for more, though. Shaq just whipping away at that Rubick, but Saxa is here. Telekinesis into stun. This could potentially secure a kill, but not with the charge coming back. He's not in time. He doesn't connect in time, and Yapzor, they need a bash. They've got the salve. Yapzor salves up. The cask bounces ping-ponged between the both of them, but Sack's a good positioning, repositions back to the side, and they've turned back onto the Witch Doctor. He's got a Fairy Fire and the Restoration, but it actually wears out as his mana is fully expended. Bambo gets the kill under tier 1 while the dive behind the tier 1 of the Dire. Rain is looking for the kill onto Saxa, but they can turn this with a stun back onto the Oracle. They've got the Batrider here as well as the Telekinesis from Yapzor's Rubick. And I don't know what the Oracle was thinking, if he wanted to snipe the Courier or something like that, because Bambo is deep behind enemy lines, tries to sandstorm himself out. But a Spirit Breaker will escape and Bambo will finally drop.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
A little bit of a mess.
Radiant's structures are fortified.
How's the Wraith King doing? What's he gone for? So Treads, 1100 gold up on him. What do you think about Wraith King?
I think you go for Blade Mail. That's a typical item build. Blade Mail into Radiance into Blink.
Radiant's I'd assume so.
And it looks really good against their lineup.
Oh, Pycat. Can you just fight through this? You don't have enough mana, even if you toggle your treads to get into another stun, but you do have the DD Batrider coming in. Vino gets hit by the Flame Break, and with a wave of terror, they've got a DD Batrider just on that Spirit Breaker's tail. The Wraith King's kind of walked into this one. Even with his ultimate up, he's not a very tanky hero. He's going to try and battle it out with Hook, but the Firefly is down. And they'll back themselves up as Wombat Gaming. They don't really stand a chance there.
I think Wombat Gaming needs to calm down and get level 6 on, all their heroes. Because the ultimates are really good. Oracle and then Witch Doctor and Spirit Breaker ultis, they're all gonna count in a team fight, and they should look to fight after the level 6.
Oh, back to your question about Wraith King. We saw a little bit of like Midas Wraith King come back when Burning did it at the summit. We saw people start to go back to the Midas build and then go into like, you know, Blink, Desolator, AC, BKB. I still kind of feel that like the Blade Mail or the Drums Blade Mail Blink build and then into the Radiance is still super strong. And up against the Sven, who's going to go Helm, S&Y, he's already started building the Sanjin Yasha. His BKB is going to be a little bit delayed because it's usually Helm, S&Y, Blink, and then BKB after.
Yeah.
Could work out for Bambo.
I like Blade Mails on the Skeleton King a lot, especially when there's heroes like Gyrocopter or Sand King who has to do damage by casting, clicking spells once. Once they cast a spell, they can't stop it.
That's true. Poor little Bambo got caught out there. He was trying to steal a stack from the Radiant, but they weren't having any of it. The thing is, though, Bambo is level 7.5, while the Spirit Breaker yet to crack 6. Do we have Bat Blink yet? He was getting close. He's got it, right? That's his gold gone. He's just had it delivered.
Radiant's top tower is under
10 minute blink on Bat. And he's still falling.
There's a smoke on Vengeful Spirit. I think they're gonna swap. I mean, they're gonna smoke to try to kill after his Firefly cooldown comes back on.
Where's the Wraith King sitting? Still up at top. He's bought something. Blade Mail it is, you were right. Blade Mail coming in, I guess, against like Firefly, Sand King, like you mentioned. Abilities can be turned back on their owners, but look at Bambo farming away. 900, almost 1,000 gold saved in the bank, 1250 away from that Blink Dagger of his own, and the initiation here from Armor's Boys is ridiculous. They've got Arcanes as well as an Urn. Let's just take a look at net worth, actually. Dire net worth here. They are outstripping Armor's Boys by 5,000 at 11 minutes.
I still believe Wombat Gaming can still make an even game through the team fights. Their team fight lineup is really strong, and Skeleton King, or Wraith King with the Blade Mail can make a huge difference in the team fight right now.
Yeah, especially with that two cycle with his ultimate, jump in, respawn, continue fighting. Wraith is, you know, kind of similar. You know, static Link, you just keep on battling through it all, try and soak up as much damage as you can with the Wraith King. Just keep that Razor. Cracking that whip from the back. The only issue is, Wraith King is going to get kited pretty well. Telekinesis, swap, sticky napalm, Sand King stuns and burrow strikes and things like that, sandstorms. So Wraith King is going to have a little bit of difficulty here sticking on a target unless he just wanders in. Well, if they go for a smoke like this, they're going to try and bait out the Wraith King here up in the front. Aria
tower is under attack.
As Just gonna sit on middle lane while the rest of his team smoke around the side, but the thing is, they have no vision. There are no observer wards up here for the Radiant. Maybe they can find Bambo. I don't know if they can see this. They see the little neutral walking across. They must have had some idea that was happening there, but they're gonna go in from the top. Pycat's the one they want. He's got Warcry level 2. He'll pop it, run himself back. The cask swap bounces back between them, but Saxa has saved his teammate for now. The two-man stun comes out, but Pycat has had all this damage drained. Saxa will be the one to fall. Pycat is still chased by Vino there, but Yapzor. Telekinesis to save for now. The rest of the Dire team, hang on a second. Bambo, what are you doing? Where are you going? Stunning onto the Spirit Breaker with a damage up on him from Yapzor. That Plasma Field steal is pretty good, but it's not going to be good enough. They see Bambo with a cast bouncing back on Yapzor. He's healing up from the Oracle's little damage burst into heal. But Spirit Breaker TP's out. Now Bambo, can you get the stun? He finds the Witch Doctor, but not the Oracle. He'll get one kill. But the thing is, the Radiant didn't get anything.
Yeah, they got the kill on the VS, I guess, but that should be much better for Radiant. Now, Razor's gonna die as well.
Oh, is he being chased and hunted? What a tragedy here for Wombat. They were the aggressors, they were looking to try and get a pickoff, but Wraith King not available for the full battle.
There was no towers around. I don't think they should have smoked towards the top. They should have smoked towards the mid where there's... And then try to find the pickoff there, and then turn it to push. And Wraith King could have helped too, because he was farming at mid. If he smoked with the whole team, it would have been too obvious. So I don't think the smoking direction was correct.
Look at Bambo's gold. Bambo is so close to Blink Dagger, 300 until he has it. But they're gonna go and try and find a pick here onto Shaq. Blink Lasso into Epicenter. Start channeling it up, and Razor in a lot of trouble here as the Epicenter comes in with a Burrow Strike, and Shaq gonna burn through from the Firefly and Flame Break. Bambo is dusted though. He's got 8 stick charges. He should be okay just to run himself away. Burrow Strike to safety. Even with a little ensnare, he should be fine. Even the charges cancelled out there by the Spirit Breaker. That's four heroes from Wombat Gaming, and they're scared to go into two. They know the ultis are down from Amos Boys. They know they're low on mana. But they're just so scared of, like, Sven TPing in, the Ventral Spirit coming in with a TP swap.
Oh, Sven's farming out of control. He's gonna have a lot of stacks to clear as well soon.
Charge mid again. Sax is in a good position here to actually swap hook back, and they cancel it out. Batrider's fine, and Pycat, he's been quiet the past couple of minutes. He's got some stacks going on the Ancients as well. That's going to be his S and Y pretty much done. Yeah, that's going to be his S and Y done. 15 minutes in, you've got a 7k net worth Sven. You've got a 6.2k net worth Batrider, and this offlane Sand King has Blink, and he's close to Force Staff if he wants it. Or I guess, like, Aether Lens and Aghanim Scepter are super good on Sand King nowadays.
Razor's not going to do anything. He's so behind, he's just gonna melt to the cleaves or his AoE damage.
He just got swapped in. Oh, they do get the ulti out, but in comes Bambo. Stuns down onto two. The death ward is good here, but Vino, he gets the ulti out to Pycat. Pycat dropping low, he's dead! Wombat Gaming have turned this really well. They've lost the Spirit Breaker, but Yapzor gonna drop to the Razor. They want to find as much blood as they can, but they'll just take the tier one. Is this gonna be it, though? Hook wants to try and grab and drag, but Arya, the Wraith King on the front lines, they can't go for it. This is not a good target. Saska, Saxa even, gets caught, but initially taken out as Bambo tries to get himself away. Hook finds the Witch Doctor on the back. The Fireflies to safety. Shaq and Arya still very low on the HP, and the Tier 1 still standing. But Mama's Boys, they lost a lot in that engagement. They can get Hook here. Stuns into Bash. Boros strikes big onto two though, and the Batrider gets himself a little bit further away with a Force Staff, which has just freshly come into him. Maybe they look to turn the TPs thick and fast as Bambo is hasted up. 2 stick charges available, but no mana for a stun. Are they still going to go for Hook? Doesn't look like it. Vino behind enemy lines. Gets the Bash. No more Bashes for you. Pycat says good night, sir.
You died well enough.
I think the Wombat Gaming, just like we saw at mid, like, they still have some chances in a teamfight if they use their even though they don't have any items, if they use their spells well, they can still win the team fight. I think they should still smoke around and put some wards in the Dire jungle and try to take down the mid tower as fast as possible. They're still restricted because all the towers are up, they cannot make so much space, and they're losing map control.
We're definitely at a deficit now. The Germans feeling it. The Greeks have taken all their money. Got nothing left.
Oh, there's a Blink Dagger on Race King now. That's important pickup.
Blade Mail, Blink, and a Smoke on the Oracle, I think there was. Yep. They're going to go for another all-in five-man play, or are they going to try and bait Arya out? He's going to go for the Blink forward, I think, here. They won't find anyone. Highcat walks it off and hides behind the tier 1. Now the rest of Mama's boys pushing tier 2 down at bottom lane. Oh, they've got a charge. They see Saxa. Ventral Spirit's going to get focused down here if they can catch up. Oh, the stun! He cancels charge and Saxa knows exactly what's going on. 7k against 6k. And the 6k player comes out worse for wear.
Oh, isn't Saxa 8k?
Oh, sorry, yeah, he's like 8k, right? 8k against 6k, the 2k difference definitely paying off. Wait,
oh,
did Hook see that?
By the Batrider.
I think Hook saw that. Bambo, Link. And again, Vino cancelled his charge to try and get another strike down. What's stolen here? Yapsil gets the charge. And Bambo setting up Epicenter level 2, Burrow Strike level 4. Could potentially find a pickoff if they got a little more firepower, and that's the Batrider. Hook's gonna walk himself in. The lack of vision here from the Radiant down in their own jungle. It's just completely dark out here. Okay, there we go. Obs ward goes down, so they have a little bit of intel. Maybe now they can see the bat. Another strike. Catches Hook. Telekinesis saved there from Yapsol and the lasso back. Vino does get dragged into a pretty precarious situation, but he just charges forward. Looking for the damage onto Hook, but the rest of Wombat Gaming say, get the hell out of here. We do not want to fight into this, because yet again, there's a tier 1 tower standing for Mama's boys. Wombat doesn't know who's going to TP in to help them.
Sven's going to clear another stacks. He's going to have a TTB pretty soon.
Oh my god. Who are they charging? All of these charges, Mama's boys know exactly when and where they're coming from. They've got such good vision and coverage. Oh, have they got the stun? They do. They've got the stun onto the Spirit Breaker. No! Not like this.
You should not have crossed me.
And now the net closes. But the slippery little fish, Wombat Gaming, do get themselves a little bit further away. Back to farming. Now what? I was going to ask, what's the item for Razor? But it looks like he's just answered that. He's gone drums into mech.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
I think he needs like a lot of items, but like I think he needs to think about the efficiency, and they have a lot of physical damage and both magical damage, but I think he needs to get BKB, I guess, because they have a lot of stuns and they just got the Roshan.
How do you deal with this Pycat, Sven? They have 2k HP plus a BKB very soon. You've got 4 staff on Mambo. So he didn't go for the Aether Lens, he's not gone straight into the Aghanim Scepter, he's gone for the, I guess, the better all-round item for staff, being able to save his teammates and stuff like that. But Saxa, what are you doing? Ventral Spirit, way, way, way out, and he gets taken down. I mean, meanwhile, up at the Radiant Ancients, Hook bash around, one more bash, no, he's got the stick charges. Hook is going to be able to get himself out with another blink in a couple, wait.
Oh, the Blade Mail plays. He burned him down with the Blade Mails.
What a god. Arya Blade Mail into the Firefly. Poor little Batrider. Oh,
that
capsules.
Just gave him 600 gold.
What does he go for next? BKB?
Radiance?
Oh, Pycat going in. 2 shots. Almost. The stun is there just in time. Bambo has the epicenter onto 3. The Burrow Strike forward will catch them as well. They've got the mech to heal up though. And they want to turn and fight. Reincarnation is here for Arya, and there was a charge coming in onto Yapzor. He doesn't have telekinesis, he's got a charge back as well, but he loses it. Yapzor can turn and try and steal something. Pycat with a BKB up, swiping through them all. They'll get the Spirit Breaker at the very least here. A 1-for-1. The Batrider did drop a little bit earlier on, but it's going to be a tier 1 tower taken by Mama's boys. And the rest of Wombat Gaming, do they want to fight into this? They've still got Reincarnation, they've got a stun, but here comes Bambo! Arya drops, Reincarnation's there, slows them down, but Hook has the lasso onto that Oracle. Death Ward dropped, and this grouping up from Mama's boys, the cask! This is bouncing between them all. They finally kill off the Oracle, but Shaq, he's healed up and kept alive through it all. This Aegis maybe from Blackout will save them until Bambo comes in with a two-man Forest Strike, and Aria cannot move, cannot run, cannot hide with a sticky napalm from Hook, getting kited left and right. And from what looked like a good start and a good initial fight from Wombat Gaming, Mama's boys just fought through it all.
Oh, this bat right is sticking napalm. I was so happy when this hero was gone from Dota. Now he's back.
See, this is why I asked if it was going to be BKB for Wraith King. Because without a BKB, you're going to get stunned, napalmed, and you're just going to stand on the spot, turning around in circles.
Yeah, I guess he needs it, but at the same time, they need DPS as well, and like, they just need everything. They need BKB and both, like, Radiance and everything. This is so hard for Wombat Gaming right now.
Well, there's the Aether Lens on the Ventral Spirit. Looks like Bambo's going to go for a Yule Scepter. I mean, that's a good item against the charge-in from Spirit Break. Good at stopping Witch Doctor ulti, if you've already used your stun in situations like we just saw. Pretty good pickup.
This is the suppression smoke. No waves are being cleared out and they're just smoking. Hopefully they get Bambo.
This is the moment where they're like, right, we've got to go kill someone, boys, and they will get sexy Bambo.
I mean, like, this is so good, but, like, this type of plays are not really gonna win the game, because even though, like, they get the kill and get, like, 1k gold, like, everyone else on the Mama boys are farming. Like, Sven just cleared out the Ancients, and now he's got a fresh blink.
Goodness.
And Rubik was farming top.
15k net worth, Yapzor. He's got a Death Ward stolen here. Telekinesis will save him from the Wraith King for a couple of seconds. We do have the rest of the team coming in. Yapzor surviving through this for a little bit longer. Oh, swap back. No, Yapzor's dead. Saxa, pretty rough situation there. Yapzor had the Death Ward. Oh, they've caught the Spirit Breaker. Stun in a couple of seconds, and Vino, he's got the charge, but he's not going to be able to get it off.
Oh, the turn rate.
Yeah, Yapzor on the Rubik, he had Death Ward, and I just know he would have loved to keep that Death Ward for a little bit longer for the next team fight.
He was pretty close to Axe, like 2k off. Just died and lost his money. We're just going for Senjin Yasha. I don't think it's a bad item either. I think he needs to static link the Sven and Kaiden. And I think Senjin Yasha is needed. In the team fight, like, Spirit Breaker needs to control the Sven, like, when he turns on the BKB.
Shaq. He got caught. He's got his mech. There are no stuns here for a couple of seconds from Mama's boys. Bambo really, really, really wants this though, and Pycat runs forward. They've got Aegis for a little while longer, I think like 20 seconds or something, until that's expired. Pycat maybe wants to try and give it up as Vino stunned through the charge. They'll get the Fade Bolt from Yapzor out as well.
Aegis ran out.
Pycat, time to bail. Stuns and disables, keeping him held in place for a little while, but there's another strike. Oh, good Yule Scepter there from Hook. Himself up into the air, he's got Blink Lasso as well. Pycat, Blink, stun, Spirit Breaker dropping low. He's got a charge, he's gonna get himself away a little bit faster, but not enough. Saxx is there with a Blink Barra Strike, and Hook has caught the Oracle. He gets his ult off, but he's still gonna get stunned into oblivion here by the rest of Mama's boys. Unless that cask is able to stop everyone dying, it's not. And here comes the tier 3 push.
Is this the standard build for Oracle 314? I think in Southeast Asia and China, people go for 2 points in phase edict. So you can use purifying flames twice.
Yeah. Oh, in a second. They're gonna go for the Shaq. The ping pong bouncing back and forth that Yapzor stole is incredibly annoying. But Saxa is gonna walk it off. Not stolen. Static Link is stolen from Yapzor. Not exactly what you want. Not really what you're aiming for. But the fact is here, Mama's boys, they're going to get out scot-free. Get a bit of damage dealt to that tier 3 tower, and they've put the fear into Wombat Gaming. If Yapzor can just get himself away, he's trying to hug the tree line, get himself into fog. Telekinesis is good for the charge. They're going to stun him up. Yapzor is a godlike player, but he's still going to die here unless he can steal a charge. They've got no more stuns. He's going to charge himself away. What a freaking godlike player. This Rubik. What are you smoking, Yapzor?
Meanwhile, sexy Bambo.
Okay, Bambo. Okay, what are you gonna do?
Beside your fountain.
What are you doing?
Space created, I guess.
What are you doing? Well, the godlike plays from Yapzor balanced out by, I don't know, the god-awful plays from Sexy Bambo running into the enemy base like that, just buying time for someone.
That's typical plays from him. Like this, he does that all the time, doesn't he?
Oh yeah, for sure, for sure. That's a Bambo play. What else have we got coming up? Any big items for the Radiant? I guess they're all trying to buy like BKBs and stuff, aren't they?
Actually has 4K.
Yeah, I just saw that. Radiance it is then, I guess.
Is it enough though? I don't think Sven cares. He'll just chop him down in 3 hits. He has no armor. Like, I guess 6 armor from Blade Mail, that's it.
And Sven just destroys him. And are they charging? Hook, blink, turn and yules. Gets himself out. Full staff up in a second. He'll be under no difficulties there to escape from that.
Oh, this must be so frustrating for Scriptbreaker. All of them has like counter, all of them have like spells to cancel his charge.
That's like the 4th or 5th stack that Pycat's taken, right? He just cleared another like 3 or 4 stack of ancients.
That range creep right here,
like, MVP,
probably like made him farm like 5k or 4k.
Insane amounts of gold incoming to him. Tier 1 up at top, this is such a slow push from Wombat. The rest of Mama's boys, they're ready for this. Down at bottom, Bambo is pushing into that tier 3. I think with the blink in from Pycat, the blink in from Hook, they're looking for the backline heroes here as Oracle spots out the Batrider. Yules himself up, but it's pushed off by that little old disable. But the trouble is, the Witch Doctor and the Razor are just being swiped down by the Sven. Oracle stuck now up on the front and one hit killed. KO and down you go. Ooh, Sexy Bambo, you've got a force, you've got a blink, you've got a stun. Let's go for this play. There's the blink, there's the force. It's not fast enough to catch the Mad Cow.
The steal? Rubik's chasing it.
Rubik stole the charge. He does another strike, but Hook is here. Stun back on the Yapzor, but Bambo, here we go. Into the old lasso, but poor Rubik. Yapzor's dead. I think with this cast bouncing between them, Hook's dead as well. The throws from Mama's boys. Running into the thick of things there. Oh, the Radiance on the courier. They cannot lose this. They know where it is. They're not going to find it, though. Bambo. Oh, the net is closed on Saxa. Try and, what, swap himself away? Pycat swapped in. Oh, they don't expect this. Pycat's up on the high ground. The Sven, the monster, the beast. And Aria, he's still got his ultimate up with the Radiance there. There's a missed chance onto Pycat as well, but Bambo epicenter Burrow Strike. Clear out the first life of the Wraith King, but now he's turned around on the stuns. He's got nothing left to give. Bambo drops, and that's 4 dead for Mama's boys. And as Sven is stuck up on the high ground, Urn will expire. He can blink.
Doesn't Plasma Field give vision?
I don't think so. Now you've asked, I'm not 100% sure.
I used to play it a lot. I think it does give vision, I'm not sure. But they should have known that because the Spirit Breaker was keep earning him, so he couldn't TP. They should have went for the Sven kill instead of the other heroes. Like, Sven is so much more worth. Dire's top tower
is under attack. This is a scary point in the game for Mama's boys, is that 20,000 net worth lead. It's been dropped by, I don't know, a good 5-6k. Experience is the same story here. Got Aetherlens on the Oracle. Shaq has pretty much got his SNY with that mech already done. And yeah, Radiance, Wraith King. We're looking at Witch Doctor. He's hit level 11, and he's getting closer and closer to that Aghanim Scepter. But the big thing here is that there's going to be another Aegis of the Immortal on Pycat.
Usually the Witch Doctor ulti does a lot, but in this case, they have a War Cry, so it negates a lot of the damage. They clicked the. I think they tried to type the timer and type GG by mistake. Actually, in one of the official matches that I played, enemy team typed GG like when we were losing so badly, when tried to type the timer and it kind of felt bad, but it is the opposite side for them right now.
What did the admin give a default loss to them? Like, did they lose the game?
They gave them a penalty. Yeah. It was a Korean League KDL.
Okay. I mean, in like Korean StarCraft 2 stuff as well, you're only allowed to like type like good luck, please pause, and good game, right?
Yeah, the rules in Korea is very strict.
Anything else, you get punished.
Yep.
Well, high cap with a blink ready. Try and look to jump again onto one of these supports at the back. That's what Hook and Pycat have been really aiming to get, is that Oracle and Witch Doctor on the back end. Make sure they don't get their sustain. Like, Kask has been MVP spell here for Wombat Gaming, honestly. Just bouncing between, like, Batrider and the Sand King, just stopping that aggressive play forward from them. But Hook is on the hunt. The Firefly up. They'll start things off with a stun onto Bambo. Got some low ground vision here from the Observer, but Hook just walks straight on into the Wraith King, drags him back as far away from the team as possible. All the way back to the ramp. But this is where they start to maybe be a little more timid. And Sexy Bambo, where did he go? I heard a Burrow Strike.
Radiant's he was strike back to the safety. He didn't go for the YOLO place. Oh yeah, he says Aegis on Sand King.
Oh yeah, you're right. I just kind of assumed it was the Sven. And maybe that's what Wombat Gaming are assuming. Because Sven, Pycat blinks forward. Here we go. Cleave hit through. The BKB's up and he takes down one. The Oracle is just destroyed. And so Shaq. The Flame Break there. They'll stun up that Hook Batrider. And I think Bambo's Epicenter. Gonna be pretty wasted as the rest of Wombat Gaming do retreat back to the safety of their fountain. But the tier 3 tower.
Didn't do anything that teamfight. He missed a stun once.
Hey, he baited out spells. He baited out spells with the Aegis, but this is where Ahri, with his reincarnation, maybe can do some work. But Pycat, he is just thwacking down these supports one after another. And Wraith King, turn rate, it's a million. He can't run, he can't hide, neither get the Spirit Breaker. Tries to battle it out, but this Batrider is causing so many issues for these non-BKB carrying cores. You know? Little Scepter missed stun there. Bambo doesn't get it out, but they've taken a lane of racks and they'll back themselves away. That's what they came for, and that's what they'll get.
So, what can Wombat Gaming do? What can Wraith King do with his 3k? I think he needs to get AC. Like, BKB is very important, but he's getting shredded too much by the physical damage.
What does Bambo buy? 3,600?
Axe? Or Endolence?
Yeah,
I'll go for Axe.
Yeah, with this much gold, I think it's going to be the Aghanim Scepter. It's such a good spell. Full map range on your Burrow Strike. I mean, who wouldn't want that? Stuns for days. And we finally got a BKB up on Hook. So that paralyzing cast from the Witch Doctor is no longer going to be a massive issue for him.
They really need to give Witch Doctor some farms to finish his... Oh, eggs.
Aria. He's got the reincarnation up, but with Yapzor here, charge through onto Hook, but the Burrow Strike is down from Bambo. Aria turns to fight. Vino tries to TP, but they're going to try and fight through this. Pycat pops. Beacon even just bashed up into the ground, but he turns. He on his ultimate. The Wraith King is dropped. That damage is being sucked away by the Razor. Shaq now battling it out. Good Yule's dodge there from Hook's back, but he's still going to get stunned up. Locked down. Bambo gets the double Burrow Strike onto two, but Pycat, that is getting kited. They've used BKB, they've used God Strength. It's all down to Bambo now. Try and get a big stun. Just try and save your carry, but he can't get there in time. Still on cooldown. There's Mama's boys. Is Hook going to drop? He's got a Yule Scepter.
What's that?
Force, Yules, and Blink. No!
Oh, he messed up.
He didn't get over the high ground. Blink. Blink. Oh, just in time. But they've got someone up on the high ground. The Witch Doctor's here. Say goodnight, Batrider. What happened in that team fight?
Razor sucked a lot of damage from the Sven, and then Sven kind of got kited by the... CC'd by the Spirit Breaker, and I think that's what won them the game. Spirit Breaker's thing work. He's catching everyone.
Just Bambo things. Can he blink? Oh, the blade mail. The urn damage ticking him down. There's the sandstorm, but it's not enough. Finally dies.
Suddenly, 3k on the Spirit Breaker.
Yeah, it was like a 6k gold swing from the fight up at the top. Is this comeback time? Aghanims for Witch Doctor, level 14, nearly 15. Spirit Breaker.
I'm on point. He got the AC.
Nice. What does Spirit Breaker get then? Because he's got BKB.
Shadow Blade. I'll get Shadow Blade.
Okay. BKB is a Shadow Blade.
Which doctor has? Like, he can't connect. I actually has BKBs and maybe Lotus Orb or Shadow Blade is something that I'll get.
There is an Aghanim Scepter on Yapzor, but you can see from the Voodoo Restoration he's got, he tried to steal Death Ward previously. It wasn't successful, unfortunately, for him.
Which doctor should never lose his Death Ward by Ruby Click, because you put the ulti down and then just toggle the heal right away. You can do that. And then you'll never lose your Death Ward and Ruby will all get some healing.
You've forgotten one key factor. Yapzor is on the Rubik. He can do anything he wants.
Oh, is he the godly Rubik player?
Yep. Like, when you think of Rubik, there's like Kuroki. He's like, you know, like the Rubik player. Then there's Seneko, I guess, has made a name for himself on Rubik and Winter Wyvern. But recently, Yapzor got himself to 7k playing like Rubik and Earthshaker support. Like, he's not a pub stomp player. He doesn't play mid, doesn't play safe lane, like, all the time. He got himself to 7k with, like, Rubik Earthshaker. He's very, very good on those heroes.
Wow. I give a huge respect for support players who hit 7k just playing support heroes. That's really hard. I never play offlaner, even though I'm offlaner, and I play solo rank. I just play mid.
Mid all the time. Well, they see the bat there. A good observe ward, gonna give them vision a little bit across. It's that high ground. Is it smoke time, though? Is it time to back out? Because without that Firefly, it's a little bit awkward here for Mama's Boys to actually try and initiate.
Oh, what a invis scout Race King split push.
Oh, that's not the play. He's just going to stand here. Just stand here forever. Oh, my God. Yeah.
That's very safe, though. I think it's a good play.
It's like the dullest thing ever. Hook. Radiant's, you're not going to be able to do this again. Shaq, maybe.
See where he is. Saw them with the ward.
Oracle pinged him out. They know exactly what's going on. Link forward, Shaq, Lasso, and Force Staff back. But Pycat's been blink stunned here with the Blade Mail from Aria. They've got the Death Ward bouncing as well, and it's bouncing between them all. The damage is good, but it's not enough. They don't have that sustained damage through, but they've got enough to kill off Zaxa. Yapzor trying to retreat. Telekinesis is up. He's not going to be able to steal anything except Empowering Haste. Finally, the Spirit Breaker gives away a spell that's not charged. So Yapzor can't get himself out of dodge, but that's another good turn by Wombat Gaming, defending high ground, stopping the aggressive play in, and now being able to push out of their base. Middle
tower is it was really attack. Good initiation from Batlighter. He blinked in, lasso Razor, fall. And then you the Oracle right away, so he can't cast the ulti. But I don't think they should push right now. The Roshan was up soon, so they could have taken the Roshan with that has the Aegis and Cheese and push the high ground. But I'm kind of worried for the Mala boys where they don't really have a good Aegis carrier. Dire's middle
tower is under attack. That was interesting. So I guess Spirit Breaker thought he could Glimmer Cape himself while charging. Cause
no, you can't do that.
You can Shadow Blade.
You can't Arc Red Swap.
You can Shadow Blade while charging, but...
Yeah. You can use Shadow Blade, you can Threat Swap, and then cast Empowering Haste. I think that's all you can do while you're charging.
Well, either way, Bambo gets himself out, and a Satanic done for Pycat. Oh, and guys, about the Rubik, I meant in Europe. Of course there's FY. Pycat swapped back by Saxa. Still gets ensnared up by that nasty little spell from Oracle. They're going to keep on chasing here with a BKB from Vino. Pycat, he's got nowhere to run. They've actually done it. They've killed off two very important heroes around the Roche Pit. They'll take it for themselves. They have to go back and defend a little bit with one hero, but they'll get this Roshan unless Hook can pull off a sneaky steal.
Oh, this Aegis is really huge for Radiant. Pycat doesn't have a buyback to put back and fight. Venting's coming in.
Burrow Strike Epicenter's good, but is it good enough? They only pop the Reincarnation for now, and Bambo is trapped in a cage of his own design as he went in aggressively. If they can catch Hook here, they've got the charge, they've got the vision, they've got the knowledge, and the intel. Rain throws out the ensnare. Yule Scepter is
purged
off. But the telekinesis holds Ahri in place. They'll get Yapzor as a consolation prize here at the very least. I don't think he's got a good way of retreating from this. And Wombat Gaming, all of a sudden, the game is theirs to lose.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's structures are fortified.
Are you worried about Mama's Boys as much as I am?
Dire's bottom tower
This Aegis is huge. Like, Aegis doesn't really mean much for Mama Boys, but because like the Sven's 6 slotted. But Wombat Gaming can use this Aegis to the full potential. It's a really good on Razor and the most risky can just one more life.
Triple Radiance Burn. That's the way to do it. Sacks away from Terra's there. Buyback from the Sand King. They're going to go in and try and steal it, but Razor picks it up already, and Hook is demolished in the pit. Meanwhile, over on the side, Sacks is forced back and out. He even swaps a creep with his Aghanim Scepter up.
But meanwhile, there was a lot of structure damage in the base. Actually, the Batrider stole the cheese, at least.
Oh, did he? Ah, yep. Okay. So he didn't get the Aegis. That's unfortunate.
I think Wombat Gaming, Skeleton King was trying to give the Aegis to Razor, so he was trying to click after Razor picks up his Aegis. But in the potential, when Batrider and Sand King can steal those kind of stuff, they should just spam the click. Like, it doesn't matter who picks up what. I had lost games like that.
Boots of travel for this Wraith King, and it's a Vlad over on the Spirit Breaker. So with that like 4,000 gold Spirit Breaker had, he went Glimmercape into Vlad. I guess they've got the damage from Witch Doctor. They've got the control out from Spirit Breaker and Oracle. And the Razor, is that Shiver's Guard, I guess? Yeah, Shiver's Guard's going to be picked up by Shaxx Razor as old Saxa. You're going to see this courier, two hits down. That was the full Shiver's Guard. Do they have a stun? Not quite. Not there in time. It's a big item to take out, but Yaps are in the middle lane. They'll get a consolation prize. They'll kill off the Rubick once more.
Oh, I don't think Sven can win against Skeleton King, Race King anymore. Race King is way too fun.
It's a scary monster, this Sven is, definitely.
Dire's middle tower.
And the thing is, he's had the same items for like 6 or 7 minutes. He's not progressed anywhere. Lasso. Catch the Oracle, but they've got the charge, the bash through, the cleave onto two. Vino gets himself into the Glimmer Cape, and Bambo gets the Burst Strike down, but Mech and Aegis up for Shaxx. The Razor just turns the fight. This is where Mama's Boys got to be happy with what they got, the one kill into retreat. Unless Pike wants to try and turn and pop the Aegis. Blink is cancelled out by that Plasma Field launched by the Razor. Not going to try and pop the Aegis just yet, unless Saxa swaps him in, but. It's a risky, risky maneuver. Bambo up on the front lines. Does he want to go for this play? He sees them, he knows they're here, but he's got no follow-through, he's got no backup. They're finally going to try and get themselves into position to fight this one. There's the one-man brush strike, doesn't catch more though. He'll scepter up from himself, he'll save him. Get back to safety.
Radiance Ancient is under attack.
Radiance Ancient is under attack, the tier 4s are all gone.
They need to care about their base. If they want to push, they should push the bottom lane anyway, because they have no structures. Oh, which doctor got picked off?
Oh, dearie me. He does have buyback, though. They need this death ward. They desperately do. Aria dragged back the Wraith King. He's going to get chunked down here. His first life will probably pop. He cannot do anything about this. And the swap back on the Vino means there's no Nether Strike and no charge to connect. Aria turns the fight. But look at Pycat. The BKB's up. Sucks is dead. And Witch Doctor, he still holds on to that death ward as he buys back into the game. Meanwhile, I think you're right. Pycat's on the run. This Wraith King just hunting him down. Radiance cancelling blinks. Yapsor is in a bit of trouble now as well. The Rubick, what can you steal? I think he just wants to try and steal the Death Ward. Let's switch Doctor Bow, the epicenter! Sexy Bambo Burrow strikes through the three of them. And now Pycat, it's his turn. It's his time to fight. The Wraith King's gone. He can buy back, but his Razor left to his own devices. Somehow the Spirit Breaker dies off to the side as well. I think that was Bambo's doing. He'll pick himself up a juicy little gem. It's buyback time here from Wombat Gaming. Get themselves back in, defend the throne. Just try and hold out as long as they can because Bambo's on the hunt. Pycat jumps forward. Aria's there as well. And Pycat, he's got no mana. He's got no stuns. He can't do any physical damage. He's getting right-clicked into oblivion. But the Yule Scepter from Bambo will save him from now. And Hook will force him back to the Flame Break. as Pycat runs and hides, and he's gonna blink away after the BKB is popped. Where the hell is Sexy Bambo? TP's up to the top.
Oh, they really needed this kill. They really needed to kill the Sven and then push the high ground and force the buyback and make the buyback status equal. Charging for a stop.
Swap back. Saxa. You're gonna die here. He's got Aghanim Scepter. He's actually very tanky, and with this, Hook is allowed to get back in. Back to the Wraith King. Ulti is available, just comes off cooldown as Arya. He could turn and fight here with a Blade Mail. He pops it. Yule Scepter up from Hook. Charge forward, but I hear the God Strength. I hear it popped. I hear the blink. I hear the stun, and Pycat. I hear his name calling from Valhalla as the Sven, the Rogue Knight, a Swedish god, slams into the Wraith King with a BKB up. No more mischance. No more Wraith King, and no more buyback. Probably no more Wombat Gaming. Finally, Mama's boys turn it on. And items are purchased. Sexy Bambo says, fuck your base, I'm getting Necro 3.
So Bambo doesn't really like the new Aghanim Scepter?
Yeah, it's kind of interesting.
I thought there was one item in the Dota.
Interesting, huh?
The books are definitely a good item against Wraith King, because he still doesn't have BKB.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Oh, Pycat. How many hits? Not enough to chop down the Oracle. And Hook in a bit of trouble here. Shaq trying to focus him down. They'll get the Batrider. Buyback from Hook. Cleave. The cleave damage. The stun is there as well. Shaq tries to battle it out with Pycat, but he's got a Satanic. And they've got that lasso. Even with this Death Ward down, I don't think it's going to be enough. It's bouncing, it's killing off Hook pretty quickly, but Pycat is there with a Burst Strike from Bambo. They'll get the Razor at the very least, and maybe even the Throne here. There's no buyback on Razor or Wraith King, but Mama's boys have taken a lot of casualties themselves. They lost the buyback Batrider. And trying just to chop down this Ancient. Bambo, he's on recon duty up at the front lines, but the Maledict is there. Yule stepped up into the air, force snap away, and he's going to pop. Look at it go. Can Pycat do this march? Can Pycat? No, he cannot. No, he cannot. Fate Edict says no. The cheese on the courier. He turns. He's got the God Strength up again. Witch Doctor, Cask ready. Glimmer Cape also available. But look at this Fate Edict. He can't hit anyone. Just focus the throne. Focus the Ancient. Kill off the support. Just do anything with a one hit crit. Down goes Oracle. But Cask is bouncing back and forth between the Vent and the Sven. And look, Wraith King. Wraith King is nearly alive with a two-man stun from Pycat. They're going to stun down the two supports. But Vino holds him in place. They've got the lockdown. They just need time for Wraith King. BKB dodges out the stun from Arya, and Pycat try and fight through it. God Strength is about to wear off and does so. And they've defended. March, they've defended their base. Saxa, he's charged. There's two lanes of racks gone. But Wombat Gaming, they're holding on for dear life.
Oh my god, there was so much kiting from the supports. Radiant's Ancient is under
attack. Oh my god. Basher for Wraith King. It's all in time.
There was a really fast swapping of item from Pycat. He instantly dropped his Blink Dagger, got cheese, used it, and Korea picked it up. I don't see the Blink Dagger anymore. Did he sell it?
From Sven? It looks like it.
Yeah.
He said, screw Blink, I have gem now, boys. He's got 8k gold, like what? Sure, just give the gem to Bat. Yeah, give the gem to Bat. What does he buy now, though? Is the big question.
I think he needs AC. I think Butterfly is actually a good item on him too. Like late game, they have no MKB. And it gives him more movement speed. Well, the AC is... he got the Butterfly.
Oh! Nifty!
Yeah.
I like that. Like, we don't normally see Butterfly on Strength Heroes. Yeah. I think the only other one is Tiny, that we see it on kind of commonly. Just for like the armor, the attack speed's pretty good, as well as the evasion on top of it.
Yeah, and then like the Butterfly gives you movement speed so you can get out of the static link.
Oh yeah. That flutter.
Rough situation.
Flutter yourself away like a butterfly. Try and sting like a bee a little bit later on. Oh, that's a Heaven's Halberd for Razor. So evasion for himself, ability to disarm that Sven as his BKB has dropped to 5 seconds now.
So, only way for Wombat Gaming to win this fight is Spirit Breaker uses ulti on Sven when he's BKB, and when his BKB wears off, the Razor needs to help use a halberd on him, and then they need to kite the Sven as long as possible while Blitz King burns everyone down. Yep. That's what they need to do.
Roshan is alive, and there's a DD rune there as well. Pika can take that for the next fight. Roshan is gone. There's no way to contest this for the Radiant as they are currently dealing with two lanes of super creeps. Roshan with a 1,000 hits and crits from Flycat. He's chucked down into oblivion. But who takes it? Who grabs the cheese? Who grabs the
There's
Aegis?
No one really useful with it, I guess.
Gonna be the Batrider.
Yeah, that's good. Decent. I'm kind of surprised Batrider didn't go for the Idolens. I thought there was a new item that made the Batrider come back to Dota.
Yeah, increased range. It's the same with Lina. Like, Idolens seems super good on Lina because it kind of reverts her back and even makes her more powerful than she ever was before. Good blink. Gets himself away and out of danger. I'm going to try and push in onto tier 3 up at top. Good swap. Oh, they've picked off the Oracle. I don't know if he has buyback. He does not. And this is looking like it's going to be it. A Shaq is lassoed back into danger. A couple of hits from Pycat is all they need, but Vino tries to hold them out for as long as he can. Where's the Witch Doctor? The ulti. He needs to use it. He's not throwing it down yet. The Death Ward is here, but he's not going to get stunned up. The bounce is bouncing, bouncing, but finally he's cancelled out and Yapzor looks at it. Go! Just for a short little while as Arya says, die. Die. Returns to its fountain. I think this is the beginning of the beginning of the end of the end for Wombat Gaming. Breaking didn't activate Blade Mail. Pycat, how many hits does it take? How much wood could a woodchuck chuck? A woodchuck could chuck wood. Well, apparently Ghost Scepter counters woodchucks. Pycat just focuses the throne. Arya dead to Firefly first. Life gone. And the Reincarnation will pop. I think, even with a glyph out here from the Radiant, they're going to lose its throne to the creeps. Insurmountable pressure of these creeps just focusing down the Wraith King and the racks and the throne. Good game is called. 54 minutes of back and forth Dota. That is what I call a game.
Yep, that was the most intense game that I have ever casted. Out of the three games that I ever casted.
Yeah, I was going to say, what's your sample size? Didn't you cast an MLG one time? Or am I remembering incorrectly?
Yeah, I did.
You did?
I think I cast it with Toby.
Yeah.
One of the finals at MLG.
So you have cast before. You have cast before. But that's it for tonight. That's it. That's our games done. We do have more games coming up tomorrow. And I think I'm going to be joined by Motpax and Blaze from tomorrow. We've got SEA starting at 2 p.m. CET. And that goes all the way through to 9 p.m. CET. We're ending up with LC versus Cookies. What else have we got? You're joining me on Wednesday for SEA,
yep.
Another MVP game. But yeah, we've got a full week and actually a full 5 weeks of WePlay group stages here. Four groups, plenty of games, best of one round robin through them all. But thanks for joining me, March. It's been great. Do you have?
It was really fun casting with you too.
Any shout outs? Any love to throw out there to anyone?
Not that really.
Oh, come on. Shout out to the MVP lads. Come on. Shout out to QO's Ember Spirit.
Shout out to his 32% win rate Invoker.
Oh!
Just got better.
The flame.
He actually had a 17% win rate with Invoker when I drafted for him, and then he still won Invoker.
Oh my goodness.
Yep. Shout out to that.
Well, thanks for watching, guys. That's it for tonight. We will be back at 2 p.m. CET tomorrow afternoon. Myself, Durka, you can check out March on Twitter, at MarchDota, myself, at DurkaDota on Twitter, Facebook, things like that. And we'll be back tomorrow at 2 p.m., guys. See you later.